At the Lillehammer Curling Hall, 8 teams took to the ice. The match between Italy and Russia got underway, and the Italians started very well. By the second end, they were 2 points ahead. Then the Russian team began to read the ice better, and by the halfway stage, they'd gathered 4 points, putting them into the lead. Both teams managed just one more point in the later stages of the match, which meant the Russians could celebrate a victory by 2 points.
I'm very happy that we managed to be the leader in our group, and we will try to stay in first place as well throughout the championship.
The Turkish team were reduced to 3 players due to an injury in a previous match. They faced Switzerland and managed to stay in touch in the early stages, trading singles in the first 2 ends. But the Swiss side gradually took control of the match, and by the 6th end, their lead was too great. 7 points to 3 was the final result. The Turkish team said it was a challenging match with only 3 players.
We have to focus more when we are playing with 3, but we couldn't concentrate well. Maybe because of his absence, so it was a tough situation.
It's very interesting here. The volunteers are friendly. They say good morning every day, and it makes fun. Because here's the Olympic spirit, and you have got one chance in your life for the Youth Olympic Games.
The United States got off to a flying start against China. By the 4th end, they already had 4 points on the board. The Chinese side managed to score 2 singles, but after the Americans added one more to their tally, the lead had stretched to 5 points to 2, and they all stepped off the ice after the 7th end. It was a solid victory for the USA.
So, you know, we've had a couple up and downs this week, but certainly these last 2 games we've been moving upwards. So as long as we keep that trend moving up, I'm sure we're all going to be feeling very well. That last game we finished very strong. We played about as good as we could possibly play, and that's very reassuring moving forward.
The team from New Zealand were still chasing their first win at these games, and they faced Japan. It was very hard to separate the sides throughout the match. Japan moved ahead 4 points to 2, but the New Zealanders pulled it back in the 5th end and went 1 point in front. Japan then levelled it again. But 2 points from New Zealand at the end of the match delivered their first victory at these games by 7 points to 5.
If you have fun while curling, you'd play better and you win, and if you're winning and playing better, you're having fun. So it always coincides. So we always try to keep really positive. And with each game, we're just gelling more. We're realising, like, oh, they need a little bit more broom, they need a little bit less. The communication is just getting more and more. So our shots are getting better and better.
We're eager to win. We really, really wanted to win. So it's a pity we couldn't proceed to the quarterfinal. It's a great opportunity for experiences. So definitely we'll learn from being here and hopefully become a better athlete in the future.
So this is how things stood at the end of the session as teams begin to think about playoffs and quarterfinal matches.